are going to discuss question on monetary policy. And the question is, what is the monetary policy committee? How does this structural innovation convert in terms of functional aspects of monetary policy in India?
Okay. The repo rate was set by solely governor of RBI.
Okay.
It was a one-man show.
Mm-hmm.
And inflation objective was to contain inflation.
Okay.
Now inflation is not solely a monetary phenomena set by Milton Friedman.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
It is also a supply side phenomena.
Mm-hmm.
Now it is the government which is more worse with supply side constraints in the economy,
okay,
and not the RBI.
Okay.
So it was decided, as is the norm in other world nations, that a committee on monetary policy, and not a single man, will decide this inflation signaling rate. That is the repo rate in India.
Okay.
So for this purpose, to impart transparency to this mechanism, a 6-member monetary policy committee has been proposed.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
The composition, it would include 6 members.
Okay.
3 would be from RBI.
Mm-hmm.
The 3 would include RBI governor,
okay,
RBI deputy governor, and 1 central bank officer.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
The other 3 would be selected by the search and selection committee headed by cabinet secretary.
Okay.
And these 3 that the committee will select will be experts in field of economics, finance.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So this in nutshell is the Monetary Policy Committee's objective and its composition.
Okay.
But my question here is that the voting rights, if there are 6 people, then 3-3 will happen. So voting rights or the MPC's final authority, who will be inclined towards RBI or government?
See, there is a RBI governor who has a casting vote. In case of a tie-up, he should have the casting vote.
Mm-hmm.
But so thereby, RBI's responsibility is made here. और एज इट इज एनपीसी आने का मतलब ही रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी और अकाउंटेबिलिटी इंस्टीट्यूट करना है विद द आरबीआई मॉनेटरी पॉलिसी. सी प्रायर टू दिस देयर वाज नो अकाउंटेबिलिटी मैकेनिज्म विद इन द मॉनेटरी पॉलिसी. सो आरबीआई वुड गिव इट, इट इज अरेस्टिंग द ग्रोथ ऑफ द कंट्री ऑल्सो, मॉनेटरी एक्सपेंशन इज बीइंग नॉट अलाउड, एंड इवन देन इफ द इन्फ्लेशन इज वेरी हाई, नोबडी इज देयर टू आंसर. But now, with the coming of MPC, some answerability will also be ensured within the monetary policy framework.
Yes.
So that is there. Another thing which is a cause of concern here is that whether this monetary policy transmission will happen or not. So that is also a concern. They are saying, how does the structural innovation convert into functional aspects?
Mm-hmm.
So conversion or transmission of monetary policy is also important. So what do you like to say, sir?
So initially, the loans which were given by banks, they were governed by base prime lending rate, BPLR.
Okay. Now,
benchmark lending rate.
Yeah, yeah.
Now, banks, what would banks do? That banks would give loans at a very high rate to normal retail lenders and give loans to corporates at a very lower rate.
Yeah.
Now corporates would borrow big amounts of money in thousands of crores, whereas retailers would take loans of very few thousands or lakhs. Now that would put a lot of pressure on banks' balance sheets.
Bigger loans can mean a bigger flood also.
Yes.
Yeah.
So that would put bigger prospects of default. If a corporate entity defaults, bank would lose thousands of crores.
Okay.
So now when this BPLR system did not work, which was a failure of India's monetary policy transmission mechanism, they shifted to
base rate.
Now banks were free to adjudicate, set their base rate without any transparency on the background calculations. This in turn would allow them to fluctuate that base rate and manipulate it as per their own whims and fancies.
So it is not directly concerned with the repo rate being set by the monetary policy. They would do it by themselves, whatever is their portion.
Yes,
I think यही reason होगा कि जो recently monetary policy है, वो या money supply है, वो market तक directly पहुंच नहीं पा रही है.
हाँ.
I think this is because of only base rate.
Conversion नहीं हो पा रहा.
हाँ, conversion.
इसीलिए MCLR एक नया format इसके अंदर आया है. हाँ, marginal cost of lending rate.
Yes.
So like you were saying कि उसमें efficiency ज़्यादा बढ़ जाता है.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. So how is that efficiency equation playing out in marginal cost?
So the MCLR system, that which stands for marginal cost of funds based lending rate, every bank would have its own marginal cost of lending term deposits. 1 year, 2 year,
mm-hmm.
3 year.
Mm-hmm.
Now, that marginal cost of every bank would be guided by its operational efficiencies.
Okay.
One bank might have a lower marginal cost of extending loans,
mm-hmm.
whereas bank B would have a higher marginal cost of lending loans. So that average cost of that marginal cost of funds
mm-hmm.
given away by bank
okay.
would form the base rate.
Okay.
Now every bank would have a different MCLR cost
okay.
depending upon its operational efficiencies.
Okay.
So now that bank would be able to link its that MCLR rate to repo rate more efficiently, which has better operational efficiencies, lesser NPAs.
Okay.
More gives loans to better creditworthy people.
Okay.
Has a robust due diligence mechanism.
Okay.
Of pinpointing lenders, borrowers.
Okay. I guess this is a wholesome effect now. You know, in the previous era, 1947 to 1997, monetary policy and fiscal policy kind of went two separate ways, right? So, for example, there is a continuous monetary expansion.
Yes.
Yeah, happening from this period, unless the WMA came into place, ways and means advanced system.
Yes.
Only after that we are trying to now converge these two policies, monetary policy and fiscal policy, and MPC can be seen as one of the ways of that convergence happening.
Right.
So in future we can see that fiscal policy being played more responsibly and in line with the monetary policy. Right?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. So that would be the conversion. Yeah?
Yes.
Okay. Good. Thank you. Thank you, sir.